with being a psych NP for the past 3 years, there are certain things that I love about being a psych NP, but at the same time, there are so many other things that I hate. And I figured instead of just showing you the good side of being a psych NP, let's show you some of the dark side of being a psych NP. And in this video, I'm gonna be going over 5 things that I absolutely hate about being a psych NP, so stay tuned. Welcome back to another episode of Life of a Psych NP. If you are new to this channel, let me formally introduce myself. I'm Darty. I'm a board-certified psychiatric nurse practitioner, and in this channel, I go over several different subjects to educate the public about mental health, ways to improve your lifestyle, topics related to nursing, nurse practitioners, and specifically psychiatric nurse practitioners like myself. So if you are interested in any of these topics, feel free to subscribe. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and smash that like button. It helps with the algorithm, and it helps me stay motivated to make more of these videos. And if you haven't followed me already on Instagram, follow me there at LifeOfAPsychNP. So, you probably clicked this video because you're interested in finding out the dark side about being a psych NP. And honestly, there are not that many out there, but at the same time, it's good to understand that there are some pros of being a psych NP, and there are some cons about being a psych NP. I know I kind of highlight a lot of the pros because I absolutely love my job and I love what I do on a daily basis, but it's important to highlight the cons because not that many people are absolutely gonna adore what they do on a daily basis, and they might want to hear about the cons before they kind of get into it, especially for those that haven't necessarily worked with the mental health patient population or they haven't worked in psych and they're just kind of jumping in. These things are definitely something that you have to always consider, especially when you are deciding about being a psych NP, because it's not going to be rainbows and sunshine all the time. There's going to be some dark days, and there's a reason why not that many people wanted to become psych NPs beforehand until it started to gain more popularity in the population, because everyone wants to be a psych NP, and it's kind of the new CRNA role. So it's one of those things that I definitely just have to give you a highlight of certain things. I want to always give you the pros because I love my job, but at the same time, it's not fair because I do have to show the other side of things. So without further ado, let's go ahead and go over my 5 cons or my dislikes about being a psychiatric nurse practitioner. So let's go. So before we get started, I just wanted to tell you about that this is my opinion. It's not necessarily all the cons, but these are the things that I believe are cons or what I dislike about being a psych NP. Some other people might disagree with me, so I just wanted to put a disclaimer out there that this is just my opinion. So if you hate these things, then just ask other psych NPs, but for the most part, I wanted to give you my opinion, so let's get started. So the very first thing that I absolutely hate about being a psych NP is dealing with drug seekers. And unfortunately, being in mental health and being in a position where we're able to prescribe certain medications such as stimulants, such as benzos, such as hypnotics, certain medications that are controlled, there are other people that are gonna come in a lot of the time and want certain medications and want certain drugs that help them throughout their whole life. And it's one of those things that we have to deal with drug seekers often, and unfortunately in our position, we have to do it. They know exactly what to say, which questions to ask, which question, how to answer those specific questions. And unfortunately, there's certain things that we have to deal with. And when we do confront them about certain medications that they've already been prescribed, especially if they're doctor shopping, then a lot of the times they're just gonna get super upset, super aggressive, and you have to deal with this on a daily basis just because of the pure amount of patients that we see. We see a lot of patients within a day, and the chances of you getting a drug seeker is gonna be relatively high. And I'm not saying all patients are drug seekers, don't get me wrong. What I'm saying is you're gonna have your fair share of patients that are coming in specifically wanting a specific drug that unfortunately many of us don't want want to prescribe that often just because of abuse potential, and people abuse these drugs and are seeking these drugs out to further either sell it or just to use it. And unfortunately, this is something we have to deal with. And when dealing with this, it gets tougher and tougher, especially when they become more aggressive, more irate, and more upset, yelling, screaming, cussing you out. And this is something that unfortunately we have to deal with. And this is the first thing I wanted to mention because I absolutely dislike this part of my job. So the second thing I dislike about being a psych NP is the fact that you're not going to heal everyone. You can do as much as you can, give them as much compassion, as much attention, as much medication adjustments as possible. You could give them the highest quality of care possible, but you're not going to heal everyone. And that's something that I absolutely dislike about my job, because you're doing everything in your power to be able to help the patient, but unfortunately, depending on what's going on, either their past or their current situation, you can't make everything perfect. You can't give them the perfect regimen of anything, because there's so many external things or circumstantial or situational things that we can't necessarily control, and unfortunately it's going to affect them in some shape or form, and you're not going to be able to heal everyone 100%. You could try to get them back to as normal as possible, but unfortunately, there's so many different external things that we can't control that you're not going to be able to heal them 100%. And it's tough, especially when you put in so much time, so much effort, and so much just willpower to be able to help them. And unfortunately, they're not going to be able to get there, just depending on the circumstances that are situational, circumstantial, external, and all of those things combined. So the third thing that I absolutely dislike about being a psych NP is how high stress this job is. And unfortunately, when you're dealing with people that have mental disorders, you're going to be hearing about a lot of the problems that they're going through. You're going to hear about certain situations that they might have been traumatic for them, certain situations that might have affected them negatively. And unfortunately, when you start to hear about all of these things and all of these stories, all of these situations with so many different patients, it's going to wear on you. And with you, them coming to you with certain answers and them wanting a solution, they're going to ask you and beg you and want so much from you, and that it's going to be extremely stressful because you're going to want to help every single person as much as you can. And as you start to do that, your stress levels will start to rise, because like I mentioned in the second one, you're not going to be able to heal every single person to the full extent. So you're going to feel super stressed out about not being able to do that. Stress levels are getting higher, and as your stress gets higher, it leads to burnout. And unfortunately, not everyone can do this job. And that's why I always stress that you need to make sure you love this patient population, that you absolutely love dealing with mental health. Because if you're not necessarily there yet and you feel like you just want to jump in because everyone's doing it, or you just want to see like, oh, I like mental health, but you don't necessarily have experience, and you jump into it, some people get burnt out so fast. So you always have to take that into consideration. There's so much stress, especially as a provider. Being a nurse is one thing, but when you're a provider, it's a whole different level. And if you can't necessarily deal with the stress and utilize certain things in your life to kind of de-stress or decompress, then your stress levels are gonna get super high and you're just gonna burn out, and it's gonna be tough for you to do what you wanna do and then positively impact patients when you don't even like being there. So it's something you always have to think about, just the high stress levels. It's not for everyone. Some people definitely don't do well in it, and some people thrive in it. So you always have to think about high stress and it leading to burnout. So the fourth thing that I absolutely dislike about being a psych NP is how physically dangerous it is. I'm not saying every single patient is dangerous, but you have to think about certain patients, especially when they're disorder, if they're manic, if they're psychotic, that they're super impulsive. And unfortunately, there are a lot of situations, especially when they're in this state of mind, they don't necessarily know what's going on in their surroundings. So they're gonna be more aggressive. You're gonna be put into certain situations, and unfortunately, it happens all the time. You'll hear about these stories where the provider gets punched out, the provider gets hurt, the provider gets kicked. I'm not saying just only the provider. It can happen to nurses, it can happen to MAs, it can happen to pretty much anyone on the unit or wherever you're at. but you're hearing about it more and more. And unfortunately, dealing with mental health patients, they're not in their right state of mind sometimes. I'm not saying all patients aren't in the right state of mind, but depending on the situation and the severity and the acuity of the patient, you might be put in a situation where you're put in a dangerous situation. Like I mentioned in other videos, as a nurse, I do help the nurses as a nurse practitioner, and I do put people in like restraints. I do help in that, help in takedowns, things like that. I get kicked every once in a while, I get punched every once in a while, I get spit at every once in a while. And it's one of those things that you kind of have to deal with it, and you're kind of knowing that this situation may take place. Obviously, you can do trainings to kind of limit the amount of times you get hurt, but at the same time, there's certain things where they're so impulsive that you're not gonna necessarily understand or know when it might happen. I'm just reading through the forums right now as we speak, where someone or a provider, a psych NP specifically, got trapped in her office because a patient wouldn't let them go. And she had to call 911 or she had to put her panic button just for people to come in. And right when the patient was about to trap them and beat them up. So you always hear about these things and you laugh about it like, haha, it won't happen to me. But you never know if you're going to be put in this situation. And it's something, unfortunately, that we have to deal with, especially with every patient encounter as a psych nurse practitioner, that this can potentially happen. So it's always something you have to think about, that unfortunately with our job, there are physically aggressive patients and you may be physically assaulted. So my fifth and final thing that I absolutely hate about being a psych NP is the fact that some psychiatrists still look down on psych nurse practitioners, even psych PAs. And it's one of those things, as a mid-level provider, from what they're saying is, they're gonna constantly look down on us just based off of the education that we've had. They don't necessarily take into consideration experience and the type of schooling that we had to go through. Also, all they're gonna be able to say is, oh, we went through medical school, we went through residency, which is great, don't get me wrong. But at the same time, it doesn't give you the right to treat us a certain way or look down on us or treat us like dicks. That's the thing, is they still look down on us as providers and they think of us as mid-level, basically their assistants. But at the same time, they don't really necessarily understand that at the end of the day, all we're trying to do is to kind of bridge that gap and be able to provide care, the highest quality of care for patients out there. And unfortunately, you're gonna deal with this type of people, deal with psychiatrists, doctors that still look down on nurse practitioners and don't necessarily know exactly what we do. And all they think about is they're in control over us and what they want is what we're gonna do, but it's not the case. And unfortunately, you're gonna meet people that way. Luckily for me, I've worked with amazing doctors, amazing psychiatrists that give me my room to grow, give me enough support to be able to take care of my patients, do all of these things. But I've heard so many horror stories from other providers where they've had psychiatrists that kind of just be like, oh, your assessment's wrong. Prescribe them this medication, not the medication you suggested. And it sucks. It's because being in a collaborative state or being in a supervising state, you kind of have to go about that, especially when they're signing off on your charts. And it's tough. And there's a lot of people that still look down on our profession. And unfortunately, you kind of have to deal with that just being a nurse practitioner. Great for other people that live in independent states. You guys are lucky. I'm jealous of you guys. But for the most part, we are still gonna get a lot of hate just for being a nurse practitioner. And you're gonna have to deal with this because you're a nurse practitioner. And doctors are gonna hate us. They're gonna give us so much crap about how we didn't go through enough schooling, how we don't have enough experience, how they went through residency, how they gained the top knowledge in medical school, which, like I said, is amazing. And I wish I would have done that route, but at the same time, I'm glad I did what I did now. So it's one of those things that you always, always have to consider, that especially when you do want to become a psychiatric nurse practitioner, that no matter what, you can have the best amount of education, the most amount of education, you could have the highest amount of experience and the best quality experience out there, but psychiatrists are, at the end of the day, they're gonna say they're doctors or we're not. We have to listen to them, and you just have to kind of just deal with their egos and go about your way. So be prepared for that. Well guys, this kind of concludes my video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I was able to provide you with information, not just only on the pros like I've done in many videos, but also on the cons and what I dislike about our role as a psych NP. Obviously, this doesn't apply to every single person out there, but this is kind of just my opinion on certain things. And I just wanted to shed light on this because it's not all sunshine and roses and daisies or whatever the saying is. It's not that. There's certain days where it's extremely bland. There's certain days where you're just going through so much crap that it's tough. But you just have to bounce back. And like I mentioned, you have to be able to consider all of these things, especially when you're wanting to choose a career as like being a psych nurse practitioner or being a psych nurse practitioner, because there are things that we have to deal with. And I know I always kind of shed light on all the good things because I absolutely love my career and I love what I do, but I need to shed light on certain things that I come across. Although I might not say it as much, but they are still annoying and I do dislike these things. So I always, always want to give you 100% of the truth and be transparent in my profession, because I don't want you to come into it thinking, oh, it's so much good with no bad. But I have to always shed light on some of the bad just so you realize that this may not be the career for you, especially if all of these things are kind of, if you hate it so much and they disrupt your mindset, and it's something you always have to think about. Well guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you made it this far, thank you so much for making it this far. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and like this video, because it absolutely helps me out so much. It keeps me motivated, keeps me wanting to push out more and more content. And stay tuned for a new series. I am going to be starting a series soon, so if you stayed until the very end, you're going to know about this series. So if you have any questions, comment down below. But I'm going to be starting a series on how to grow and start a private practice. So I'm excited about this series. I don't know how many episodes, but pretty much this series is just going to talk about certain nuances, especially when starting your private practice, if it's right for you, how to do it, what steps to take, things like that. So stay tuned for that. And guys, as always, have a wonderful day. Until next time, bye.